Carlisle again was talking about, somebody asked him, he was asked, was it part of the mindset this offseason to get a little protection for those situations where people like to knock around Luka a little bit? And Carlisle just said matter-of-factly, yeah. Like, yeah. You know, he talked about some players they had, you know, James Johnson, his toughness, Josh Richardson, obviously.
But the very, very tough-minded Dwight Powell.
You know, he's coming back from an Achilles injury. That requires toughness. I wouldn't say that Dwight Powell was an enforcer on the court.
We're talking about two different kinds of toughness.
Yeah, yeah. I think Dwight Powell is mentally tough.
Maybe.
In the way of...
We've never seen him in a playoff game.
Well,
you know?
True. But just being able to come back from that injury, I think, requires that mental toughness. But if you're talking about, like, enforcers, guys that are going to stand up for Luka when he's getting pushed around, I never really saw Dwight Powell do
anybody.
That. But
yeah.
Anyway.
Maxie, I think, would do that more than Dwight.
Yeah. Yeah, but yeah, Carlisle, I think he said something like, you can never have too much crazy. Or it's nice it's nice to have a little crazy on the team. So, yeah, I mean... But here's the other thing. Do you think Luka still needs the enforcer like we thought he did last year? Like, do you think that stuff is even going to affect him anymore?
Well, I don't know if it's going to affect him, but you also don't want... You don't want the perception of being soft.
True, yeah.
And you don't want people taking liberties.
Yeah.
So you need a guy that's going to come in, and when Kawhi... If they're going to hit Luka... And this is what didn't happen last year, you know, when that Marcus Morris flagrant foul.
Everything he did.
That's where you bring in James Johnson, and he karate chops Kawhi when Kawhi goes into the lane. He does a flagrant foul.
A karate chop.
Yeah, I mean, whatever they do with a black belt, you know.
Yeah.
And then Kawhi will go to his teammates, hey, don't mess with Luka because I don't want to get hit when I go into the lane.
Yeah, I mean... I think that's a good point, is that you don't want it to continue. And that was one thing that kept happening last year was like, it wasn't just, you know, when he would drive, you know, it would happen one or two times. It would start in the beginning. It would continue the entire game.
At what point would James Johnson elbow Marcus Morris?
He would probably do it anyway.
Yeah.
Just because.
Just because. But why would
Marcus Morris
not... Stop! If he's not getting hurt, if he's not getting leveled, like, you think he wants to go up for a dunk, afraid for his life?
Yeah.
But he didn't feel that because nobody was doing it back to him.
Yeah.
So I think that's really what you need, is somebody to say, "Hey, look, okay, if you're gonna do that to our guy, we're gonna do that to your guy."
Yeah.
And nobody on the Mavs did that.
That's a good point, because it just kept going. I mean, I remember there was a game, I think, against the Lakers and the Clippers, where going into halftime, he's like, he's got blood on his head. He's on the ground every time he drives it. And the refs aren't going to call that, apparently.
Well,
so you need a guy to say, like, that's not going to happen. You're not going to do
and
that.
And you hear Luka in the press conferences or after the game talking about, you know, he's saying a lot of things to me and blah, blah, blah. Nobody got in his face after that.
Yeah.
Like, if I was...
I mean, Kristaps tried. But
yes,
also, you don't want a star doing it because for the same reason. He gets ejected.
Yeah, but you want a guy that's crazy.
Yeah.
Like James Johnson. And next time Marcus Morris goes in for a dunk, that ain't going to happen, and then I'm going to get in your face and tell you why it's not going to happen.
Yeah, and if I get ejected,
so be it,
you know.
As long as you know.
Yeah.
You know, you need to shut up, you know, when you're talking, you know. Nobody did that for the Mavs. I think that's what they were lacking.
It reminds me of that, it's an old video of Ron Artest and Tyler Hansborough, when Hansborough, I think, got hit or something from behind, and he turned around to get in whoever was it, and he saw it was Artest.
And
he was
like, oh my God, yes.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to.
And there's certain people, like Ron Artest is one of those guys, you don't get in his face, not because he's crazy on the court, but he'll probably find where you live and slit your throat at night.
But and so you probably knew to also not mess with his teammates, too,
because
you don't know what he's going to do.
He was a little crazy.
So, you know, I'm not saying James Johnson's like a psycho or anything, but you need a guy like that to where... It's like, we're not going to do that.
Exactly.
Okay, you're not going to do that. It's not going to happen. We're putting an end to that. So my question would, like, is that going to bother Luka anymore?
I don't think that.
I don't know if he'll care. Obviously, no one likes getting knocked around, but I don't think it'll get to him mentally like it did last year.
I think he learned so much from this playoff experience.
Mm-hmm.
He learned that, one, nobody can stop him. It just, there is nobody on the planet.
Kawhi didn't stop you.
That team was built to stop you. They had every great wing defender in the league. They were built to stop you, and you crushed them.
Mm-hmm.
You embarrassed them. And so I think it told him there is nobody that can stop. As long as I'm focused, as long as I don't get knocked out of my own game, then there's nobody that can stop me. And I think throughout the season, that would happen a lot.
Yeah.
He would get knocked out of his game because, you know, he's 20 years old. And that's what you do when you're playing a 20-year-old that's just better than you. You push him to the ground.
Yeah.
And but now he learned if they push me and they talk to me and all that, if I just stay focused, there's nothing they can do. And I think that that's bad news for the league.
Yeah, I think last year he it was like he thought those things were affecting his game, but basically now it doesn't matter what people do. He realized he can still score. Whereas mm-hmm. before it was like, oh, they're not calling a foul or mm-hmm. they're knocking me around or they're, you know, whatever, getting in my head, it's messing me up. Where it's like, no, those things aren't, like, you're letting it mess you up. If you just play your game, you're unstoppable. And like you said, against the Clippers, he averaged 31 points on 50% shooting. Mm-hmm. And that's with Kawhi Leonard, Paul George, Patrick Beverly, all these guys that were meant to stop him. He Marcus straight up, Morris. Yeah, Marcus Morris doing all of that crap that he did. Mm-hmm. And even that affected Luka, but even then he still had he almost averaged a
triple double. But it didn't affect him the same way.
True, like, after a while, yeah,
it didn't affect him the same way it did early in the season. All it did was make him want to play better, yeah. You know, and to prove that you're not going to stop me by doing these kind of things.
Yeah, so I think now it's all you have to do is play your game, and they can't stop you. So I do think that Luka will handle those situations differently, but you still need a guy that's like an enforcer.
Mm-hmm. You need a guy that if you get pushed and you turn around to fight him, you realize who it is. You're like, oh, never mind. I'm sorry, dude. Black belt thing. Yeah.